Ladies and gentlemen, good day and welcome to the Q1 FY24 earnings conference call of Entertainment Network India Limited. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in the listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star, then zero on your touchtone phone. Please note that this conference has been recorded. I now hand the conference over to Ms. Runjhun Jain from EY Investor Relations. Thank you, and over to you, Ms. Runjhun.
Thank you, Jacob. Good evening, everyone. We welcome you to the Q1 FY24 earnings call of Entertainment Network India Limited. To take you through the results and answer your questions today, we have management team from the company here, represented by Mr. Yatish Maharishi, Chief Executive Officer, and Mr. Sanjay Balam, Chief Financial Officer. The financial results and the presentation have already been uploaded on the company's website and on the exchanges. Should you need any further information, you can reach out to us at EYIR team and we would be happy to send it over to you. Before we proceed with the call, a disclaimer. Please do note that anything said on this call during the course of introduction and in the document which reflects the outlook towards the future or which should be considered as a certain forward-looking statement must be viewed in conjunction with the risks that the company faces and may not be updated from time to time. With that said, I will now hand over the call to Mr. Yatish. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Ranjan. Good evening, everyone. First of all, I'll extend my best wishes to all of you as our beloved country celebrates the 77th year of independence. On behalf of ENIL, I extend a warm welcome to all of you for joining our Q1 FY24 earnings call. I hope you had the opportunity to delve into our quarterly results. However, I would urge you to look at the positive underlying trends and not look at just the overall results. Please allow me to navigate you through the results. Overall media industry, if you look at in the Q1 performance, has remained subdued both in revenue and margin terms. This has largely been impacted by the global macroeconomic factors. Media sector performance has been far from good. If you look at television or print, the numbers have not been very, very encouraging. In fact, radio shines as a standout performance in the traditional media space, as been evidenced by our industry peer results also. Coming to our performance, to begin FY24 with a distinctive upswing in profitability gives us enough delight to share the results. There has been a marginal dip in revenues, but we have managed to improve our EBITDA and EBITDA margin significantly. The revenue dip was partly due to the absence of TV properties, which we do in the quarter four, and which rolls into the quarter one also in our solution business, and also the factor contributing to the subdued revenues in the solution business has been our deliberate strategy to focus only on profitability and only the events which are profitable to us. Shifting our focus to the core existing business, which is the radio business, it has achieved a healthy 8% growth, predominantly led by a remarkable 17% growth in volume, which has been the story for the last few quarters. As a management team, and in the previous quarters I've been saying, our unwavering focus continues to be on profitability of the business and making our existing radio business more lean and more agile. In terms of profitability, if we exclude the digital investments which we have been doing over the last quarters, our EBITDA stands at 19 crores, signifying a robust growth of 59% year-on-year growth. The margins have improved to 21.7% against 12.8% in the same quarter last year. This accomplishment has been a result of, you know, a commitment of stringent cost-saving measures which have been doing over the last few quarters. Our solution business, though at a lower revenue, has demonstrated an improvement in margins from 34.8% last year to 43.1% this year. Similarly, if you look at our existing business, excluding the digital and DVC, our cost base has undergone a 6% reduction, showing our strategy to make our radio business very agile and lean so that we run an efficient operations. And that's not it. If you look at our PAT also, for the first time in the last few quarters, we have turned profitable if you exclude our digital investments. We remain committed to invest towards our future towards digital. During this quarter, we infused an additional 7 crores on our digital foray, Mirchi Plus, which has been demonstrating good growth on overall all parameters and which gives us immense satisfaction. Our focus on sustainable, profitable growth extends to our international business as well. To move away from, you know, the loss-making ventures which we had, we have closed operation in San Francisco and undertaken rigorous cost-cutting initiatives in overall U.S. business. In Bahrain, we have recalibrated our operations at negotiated prices to make it more profitable. As a result, our international business has also turned profitable during the quarter, and it has supported our profitability on a consolidated level. Our balance sheet remains very, very strong with a cash reserve of Rs. 248 crores as on June 30, 2023. As we have always promised that our aim remains maximization of shareholders' value and continue to focus on profitability and we'll continue taking those measures. With that, I will hand over to Runjun to invite for questions. Thank you.
Thank you, Yashish. Jacob, we can open the floor for question and answer.
Thank you very much. We will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on their touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. The first question is from the line of Deepan Shankara Narayan from Trustline PMS. Please go ahead.
Good evening, everyone, and thanks a lot for the opportunity. So firstly, from my side, so what would be the contribution of platform business alone in this quarter, and what is the contribution of digital for the overall business?
Okay. Deepan, you follow up with the question or?
So this is one of the main questions for me.
Okay. So, Deepan, to answer you, our digital revenue has been almost 7.86 crores as a total digital contribution. And if you look at that, a percentage of radio revenue has been about 11.9%.
Okay, so in that, how much is the platform and how much is YouTube and other digital revenue?
So, the Mirchi Plus platform, which is our own app, we have still not started monetization on it. But if you look at pure digital revenues, it would be 5.7 crores and 2.09 crores. 2.90 crores comes from other components. And if you look at, and to give much more perspective, the revenues from YouTube has been about 1.35 crores. Syndication revenue comes to about 3 lakhs, and the amping revenue which we have been discussing with you over the previous quarters is almost about 1.6 crores.
So amping, how much did it contribute previous quarter, Q4?
Last quarter?
Yeah.
Just give me 1 second. Last quarter is about 2 crores. This quarter has been 1.6 crores.
Okay, okay. So on the scalability of emping business, so nowadays we are able to see a lot of ads coming up in Spotify also. So like this, we are planning to extend this to further to all other internet platforms as well. So what is the kind of scalability possibility here, and what is the kind of market share we have in this business currently?
So, Deepan, to answer on this, yes, we are looking at more and more tie-ups and more partnership with all audio OTT players. That's what we have been aiming to, and that's the reason if you look at our performance on emping has been up and down, because as we partner all on board, everybody came, most of the partners are now on board, which came in last part of Q4 and the current mark and current quarter. So now we have almost, if you look at the major OTT players, we've almost covered 90% of the inventory. If from a competition point of view, there is one player which is there, which is a small player, but they'll be the only player in this space if you look at an independent player. I'm not counting Spotify selling their own revenues or any platform selling their own revenues. As a third party competition, there's only one competition in this space. Having said so, the margins are very, very healthy as we speak right now. And we believe as the markets open up, and because there's been the overall market conditions were not so great, but as we speak, I think the numbers can be multi in 2x or 3x of these numbers.
Okay. So if not Spotify, then what other kind of platforms are we selling MPIN currently?
Sorry?
Other than Spotify, what other platforms are we selling MPIN currently?
So there are many. If you look at, there is Spotify, there is JioSaavn, there is Pocket FM, there are a lot of gaming companies. So there are lot many. There is ST, STCast, there is Wynk. So there are many, many guys. So we have aggregated most of the audio OTT players, and our focus remains largely on the audio segment.
Okay. And on the solution business, so the current quarter, the solution business around the 20.87 crores, right?
Yeah.
So which has been down, fallen from the previous quarter. So otherwise, outdoor has been doing well for most of the players. So any specific reason?
Yeah, so in my opening remarks, if you remember, Dipen, I put it across, our solution business constitutes the TV property business, which we largely do in the quarter four, but there is always overflow in, which flows into the quarter, some, a lot of revenues flow into quarter one also. And if you remember, in the quarter four revenues, we didn't do our major properties, which are the Mirchi Music Awards in various languages, simply because we believed in profitability of running a business and not just gaining revenue. The impact of that not doing the event has gone into Q1. But if you look at overall solution business, barring that, the growth remains quite encouraging. But the good part is the margins keep improving on that part, on that business also.
Okay. Lastly, from my side, so this 7.8% growth in radio business, that is mostly from volume growth itself, or and also, are we seeing any scope for increase in the yields in near future?
So the price has, good part is the price has stabilized. It doesn't look like going further down, and that's what we not, we won't, we don't want to look at any look pricing going down. There's been marginal growth in the metro markets, but the second frequency station and the batch one station still lag behind. But it's been very, very marginal. I would not comment very heavily that there has been very great improvement. Yes, you are right, the major growth has come through volumes. But at least the price has stabilized, not going down. Compared to last year, the price is stable. If I look at eight stations, which are the top eight metros, the price has gone up by 1.5%-2%.
Okay. Thanks a lot. I'll join back in with you.
Thank you.
Thank you. A reminder to all participants, to ask a question, you may press star and one. The next question is from the line of Suresh Shetty, an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Sir, is the audible?
Yes, please proceed.
Hello, sir. Actually, you are sitting on cash around 250 crores, but why you can see the balance sheet in loan 250 crores, sir?
Thanks, Suresh. Could you just specify again?
Actually, your report, you will give the sitting on cash some 200 crores you can in investor presentation. But in financial statement, has borrowings around 250 crores, you can see that. What is the difference between this? I'm not understand the tale.
I'll ask Sanjay to help you with this one.
Hi, Suresh. So yes, you are right. On the cash and cash equivalent, we have 248 crore as on 30th June 2023. However, what you are currently seeing as liability is not actually a financial liability. It is the impact of Ind AS, Indian Accounting Standard related accounting impact, which we had to take as per the accounting norm. There is no real loan or anything or debt we have, the company has taken, either in the current quarter or in earlier quarters. The company remains completely debt-free.
Completely debt-free, no?
Yes, it is completely debt-free.
Sir, one more question.
Since 2019, the company is completely debt-free.
Sir, one more question. Sir, actually, last time some person calling, what is the opinions of investors in the business side, in is a survey type of asking the person. I will give some opinions. But sir, you know Sarigama Carnival. The type of carnival. ENIL also so many programs is conducted. The type of events we can earn the more profitability is you conduct presentations and programs in YouTube. Small events you will give the type of you can understand sir, I know little bit English. Hello.
Okay, Suresh, can I take this question?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I think you are mixing couple of things. Saregama and the product launched by them, Karwa, etc. is a completely different segment and different business. Being a listed company, we are not authorized to talk about their performance and their financial numbers. If you have any specific question and query about our performance or our numbers, you can mail it to us, to the mail ID is given in the investor presentation.
Thank you. Mr. Shetty, may we request you to come to the question queue? The next question is from the line of Shubrata Sarkar from Mount Infra Finance. Please go ahead.
Yeah. So, sir, my question is like what we are seeing from your performance as well as a few of your other competitors. Radio ad volume has now back to pre-COVID level. In terms of volume, I am talking about. But in terms of like ad rate, we are still far below that. So, what is our take on that? Are we thinking of like raising the rate? And if so, like from what time period? We are looking for raise it and at what quantum, if you can throw light on that.
Thanks, Subrata. So if you look at, yes, the business has been driven by volumes. The volumes are not, for us, the volumes are higher than pre-COVID levels. We remain always the best in the industry in terms of running less volumes and more and playing more music. So we still have a lot of headroom in terms of the volumes available. If you look at the capacity utilization also right now, we are about 70% of the capacity we have. On your question on pricing, yes, the pricing remains subdued. It's a function of supply and demand. Generally, pricing in media is improved in the second half of the year, and we believe some bit of pricing improvement you will see in the quarter three and quarter four. We believe that we should look at quarter three and quarter four. Good part is the pricing is now stabilized. It's not going down at all. And we believe we will be able to improve price in quarter three and quarter four.
Okay. Okay. And sir, second question on the more of a generic question, but on the digital side. So, our performance has been improving in terms of like viewership and all those things. So, what is our details plan on like monetizing it? To be very frank, what are the multiple levers we can have, and how? What is our priority on those side, and how we are planning it?
Yeah, so on our digital foray, if you just look at app, see there are two verticals for the digital strategy. If you look at, there is an mweb and there is an app. Mweb we've been monetizing through our multimedia solutions and using that. But if you look at pure app, which is our Mirchi Plus app, we believe in, you know, building the content right now. We still have about 3,000 hours of content. We would ideally want it to take it to 10,000 hours of content, build us a very, very good base of consumers, and then look at monetizing. So we keep doing experiments in terms of looking at subscription models and both ad revenues. And basis that, as we have a critical mass of content available in various languages, we will get into the monetization part. I hope that answers, Subrata.
Yeah. And sir, last question on our event and outdoor activity, like what is the current situation right now? Because it was muted, to be very honest. And sir, one thing, previously we were sharing each of the verticals like revenue or growth. Now we have merged it to radio and others almost. So if we can share that data will help us. And as I told you, like outdoor activity, are we anticipating, like Q4 was very weak, so are we anticipating real pickup on that side?
Yeah, so if you look at, yes, if you would have gone through other industries earnings call and all, every company is now very, very bullish about doing A&P spend both in media and activation. If you read maybe Dabur or Levers, everybody is looking at, you know, increasing the spends. And we believe, we are also very bullish in the event segment, that the second half will be much more, much better than even last year. And for sure, first half. Generally, the event business is skewed towards the second half of the year. So we believe the event business should be back in the second half of the business.
And
on the investor deck, all the data is available. We have not merged it. It remains that you might have to just look at it again. If there is anything specific you want to know, please do write to us. We'll be very happy to share that.
Okay. So my last question on the government ad side. So is there a traction that is coming back? Because if for other media, there is some traction we are observing, number one. And number two, sir, since election is due next year, first half, so are we expecting very good ramp up on that side in the Q3, Q4 and Q1? So H2 and Q1.
Yeah, so there are two aspects to it. One, we believe the pricing in government, which has been not been raised for the past few years, we believe that would lead to a change. So that will also have an impact on overall government revenues. We believe that should happen in a quarter or so. On the government, yes, you're right. Whenever there are election period and a year prior to the election, the government spends goes up and also the political spends come up. In fact, not just central government elections, even the state government elections, we believe in MP, Chhattisgarh, Rajasthan, we believe that, and even Andhra and Telangana, we believe there will be a ramp up in government and political spends. So yes, in the second half, we anticipate good amount of government and political spends to happen.
That's all from my side.
Thank you.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, to ask a question, you may press star and one. A reminder to all participants, to ask a question, you may press star and one. A reminder to all participants, to ask a question, you may press star and one. The next question is from the line of Deepan Shankara Narayan from Trustline PMS. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thanks a lot for the opportunity again. Sir, I'm just trying to reconcile revenue number for Q1. So radio is 67.83 and solution is 20.87, and but overall digital is 7.86. So rest of that contributed by which part, sir?
Yeah. One second, we'll come back to you. Give us a moment. So basically, what happens, Deepan, that when we report the digital numbers, the digital revenue is generally distributed among many other revenue streams. So a direct addition of the numbers may not always give you the arithmetically correct answer. Let me tell you the numbers for the current quarter. So digital content solution in this quarter, the revenue was 2.75 crore. And digital components, which was available in other segment, which was present in other segments, that was about 2.09 crore. My digital platform, including MPing, etc., we earned about 3.02 crore. So total was 7.86 crore.
Total was 7.86 crore. So in that, in the investor presentation, we have mentioned the non-FCT plus the digital platform. Then we have given non-FCT separately. And if I take only that digital platform, that is around...
So you are right, absolutely right, Deepan. So the non-HCT portion, which we have mentioned, that does not have, on the first slide, if you go, which has been uploaded today, it will have non-HCT plus digital platform. And at the end, we have not separately mentioned digital platform, the numbers which I have called out right now.
Okay, so the rest of the digital revenue form part of HCT, is it?
Yeah, some of them. Not necessarily all of them, some of them.
Okay. Sure, sir. Thanks a lot.
And just to clarify you, there is no HCT component in the digital component. Just to remove the doubt that in the digital revenue, when we report that, we do not, there is no HCT component which is included in that.
Did you get it, Dipen?
No, it's still not clarified, sir. The 7.89 plus if I add solution, so the solutions include this digital component also?
Yes.
Solution
so so Dipen, just to give an explanation, pure digital component is about 2.09 crores. In our solution business, when we do multimedia solutions to a client, there is a digital component of that also.
Okay.
So that is about 5.77 crores and also our original content properties. So when you look at solutions, there is the digital component and then there is the pure digital play also, which is the YouTube revenues, syndicated revenues and MPing revenues.
Okay.
Yeah.
Got it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Ankit Patel from HSBC Securities. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi. Thanks for taking my question. My question was regarding the radio business. So, I mean, compared to, say, history FY19 or FY20, if we compare the radio business EBITDA generation, we are fairly off from there. So, just want to understand the management's outlook in terms of how, you know, you see the radio business recovering. What part of the recovery do you think has already come through? By when do you see it recovering, and to what extent will it actually be able to recover in terms of those peak levels of EBITDA generation? And the second part is you also have cash on the book, so are you looking at any ways to bump up this radio business in any way?
So thanks, Ankit. First, I'll answer your last question. Yes, we do have cash. We keep evaluating opportunities available in the market, both in traditional and digital space. As and when we get a right opportunity at the right feasibility, we will look into it. So that I would answer that on the investment part to look at it. If you look at, yes, the EBITDA percentage numbers have been good. The problem has been largely the revenue. The revenue has been down because the price, the yields have gone down and the volumes have gone up. So as we, you know, get the right mix of pricing and volume and the business goes up in radio, you will see that numbers coming back to pre-COVID levels. And also, if you look at on the event side, also the business has been a bit subdued over the last two quarters because of the overall economy segment. But I think the second half, we should be looking at a pre-COVID number if you want to look at, if you want to say that. Just the second half, not saying the full year basis. But on the second half, we would be bullish to look at the event business doing well. And also, with when you look at the commentary of all industries, everybody looking at spending monies in the second half, we believe the traditional media also should have a decent growth in the second half of the year.
All right, thank you. The other question, sir, was on this license fee for the radio business, which is, again, a fixed expense that you incur. Now, if the yields and if the mobilization of, you know, new revenue over there is behind, is there any way to address that? We actually heard in other calls that, you know, there is a representation being done to ministry to look at this. So, just want your views on, you know, how this is likely to progress.
Yes, Ankit, you're right. There has been a representation on that to support the industry. We have been asking the government to support the industry on this front. In terms of the license fee, which is a function of the license or the revenue. So there has been a strong representation, and we would want to believe that government will look into it. considering that new auctions have also been announced. I don't know if it will be soon or, but at least they have announced it. Part of that, they might look into it, which could be a good jump for all, for the entire industry. And we would really, really welcome that. But it remains with the government. We have been doing our job of doing the representation very, very strongly on that.
Right. Okay. Thank you.
Thanks, Ankit.
Thank you. A reminder to all participants, to ask a question, you may press star and one. Ladies and gentlemen, to ask a question, please press star and one. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one. As there are no further questions, I would now like to hand the conference over to the management for closing comments.
Thank you very much. Thank you for joining the earnings call and your continued support over the years to the company. We look forward for this continued support in the coming years also. Thank you very much. I'll hand over to Runjun. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your
opportunity, and we look forward to host you again. And any other question if you have, you can reach out to us. We are happy to help you.
Thank you.
Thank you. On behalf of Entertainment Network India Limited, that concludes this conference. Thank you for joining us, and you may now disconnect your lines.